Diving for me was never just about exploring. It was a way to connect deeply with the ocean. And once you really connect with the ocean, it is impossible not to care.
Fascinates me, it intrigues me. I want to know more about it. And I want to discover more and more.
I've always felt a connection to the ocean. Like whenever I'm in the water, I feel comfortable, I feel free.
A time where I can just breathe and think of nothing else other than being in the ocean, because it takes away all other thoughts.
If I have to describe ocean in just one word, I would say life.
Most of our oxygen comes from the ocean. Most of people's livelihood can come from the ocean. So life is all around the ocean. Ocean is life.
I originally Koh Tao people. My family is local here. My grandfather is the first one, the first generation that come to here to do the coconut tree and then pass to my dad and then pass to me. My house is not far from here, it's nearby the beach. So when I was a kid, I always run around on the beach, swimming all day in the ocean.
Over the last 25 years, the development on Koh Tao has been pretty significant. When I first got here, you always felt sand on your feet. Most people didn't wear shoes.
When I grow up more and more, I see change that happen in Koh Tao because more customers come in, more tourists come in, more development can happen.
I've seen the changes in the environment. I've seen the effects close up of climate change.
I got to the point that I want to protect the environment that I can.
I'm a PADI course director, so I've spent the last 25 years teaching people how to dive. And I'm also an active conservationist in the local community. I wanted to integrate conservation within the new dive centre.
What we can do to stop the damage we will, it's maybe small change, but we start from every little thing.
I'll tell you my strategy to convince people to take care of the ocean. Take them diving. When they look around, when they see the reef, and when you talk about it and people really understand what they've been seeing, they will want to protect it. They will love it because it's gorgeous.
In order for people to care, people have to get to know the oceans better. They have to get to know what creatures are living there, how exciting it is underwater. And the better you know something, the more likely you are going to care about it.
There is life everywhere. I think anybody that sees and realizes how beautiful it is, how important it is, we want to do something to keep it like this. We want to do something to protect it.
Conservation workshop that is part of the DM program at Black Turtle is something, I, to be honest with you, I didn't really think I'd enjoy. However, after completing the workshop, meeting Iora, a few of the other people who are involved in the conservation, I kind of realized that it's something I want to pursue further.
It's like a playground. I look around, I see all this diversity now after having done the whole ID course. It's like, oh, I know you, I know you, I know this one. This is Parites, this is Pacillopora. The more you can name things, the more you also get attached to it and can actually love it.
The depth of knowledge they have is just incredible. I love speaking to them, and you don't realize until you go on a dive with one of them, you're looking at things that I had never even noticed before. They're writing notes, and I just find that so fascinating and intriguing, and something that I would love to understand more. I'd love to know what it is they're writing, what it is they're surveying, what it means when there's 15 nudie branches spotted in 5 minutes, or what it means if there's only two. The deeper insight into the things that everyone kind of takes for granted when they dive and just look at it and go, oh, that's cool.
I just realized that everyone was really afraid of touching the corals, for example, but people didn't really have the knowledge of why was that important, right?
My dad generation, they don't know what is coral. They thought it's just like one rock because it looked like the rock.
From the moment people think that the coral is a rock, it's not a living organism, it's not an animal, so why would I care about it?
Corals don't grow overnight. Corals take years and years and years to grow, and it takes one dive for it to be destroyed. The impact of one misplaced fin on a coral can destroy it solely.
It's essential that as scuba divers, we educate our students into good, solid conservation practices.
Here at Black Turtle, we are teaching our divers a little bit more. We're teaching them ways how they can perfect their buoyancy so that we're not damaging the coral.
People have to know more to understand it, to be educated, because I don't think it's a malicious thing from anyone. No one deliberately goes out and thinks, right, I'm going to destroy coral, I'm going to litter, I'm going to do this. I think it's an uneducated aspect of it. So I think if we can just educate people and just try the best to kind of broaden everyone's horizons.
For me, scuba diving and conservation, they go together, and I wish that more scuba diving instructors would actually teach conservation, that they would know more about marine life and pass on that knowledge.
I think our main challenge right now is to make not only divers aware, but also the diving schools.
Customers in 2025 are more savvy and are more educated, and there's a much larger percentage of the customers that visit Koh Tao now that are looking for a scuba diving experience that is conservation friendly.
I think marine conservation is evolving because more people is joining, basically. There is more people who's interested in creating something good and creating a good impact while diving.
I want to do something that goes beyond myself, or that's not just for me, that's for this world. Like, I want to protect this planet. I want to protect the beauty of this planet.
They're looking for a dive center that has high standards, not just training standards, but conservation standards as well. And I think the Black Turtle brand resonates with a large percentage of the new generation's values.
We're not here to repeat the same mistakes. We're here to learn, adapt, and do better.
We need to understand that we put a lot of pressure on the environment, and we need to ensure that we minimize the amount of pressure. We're visitors to the ocean. As the famous saying goes, leave only bubbles and take only memories.
Many people come 1,000 miles away to come to see what we have. I want to keep this to show the world how beautiful we are and how peaceful we are. And it's not only about natural, it's about people as well. Koh Tao people is really kind.
I love Koh Tao. It's really beautiful.
Everybody is out here for the love and the enjoyment of diving.
In Black Turtle, we're quite passionate about conservation. It's not only me, all my staff is passionate.
our conservation programs are not only about conservation. It's also about to build a community of people who is passionate about the ocean and who wants to contribute and do something good.
You get to meet people from all over the world who are all excited about diving, who are all excited about conservation.
For me, it is totally inspiring to be around people that want to do their best to protect the ocean and to educate people, to pass this knowledge on, to actually make a change in the world.
It's inviting and it makes you stay, it makes you want to stick around, it makes you want to progress, to learn more. And I see what they do on the boats. I see ecological monitoring surveys, the coral tats. And for me, I'm like, I want to be involved. I want to know more.
Here you get to connect to other people who are just as passionate, who are just as hopeful, who are just as willing to fight for our oceans, for our planet, for things to get better.
At Black Turtle, we bring together conservation, science, research in every part of our program.
The objective isn't to become bigger. The objective is to become better. I would like to think that we can grow the science, research and conservation side of the business.
Marine conservation to me is a purpose. It gives me a purpose. It makes me want to wake up in the morning and go out there and I know that I'm doing something useful.
Marine conservation is a large part of why I dive. Broadening my knowledge is something I really want to do, how I want my diving career to progress.
The more environmentally sound we become, the more that people will want to come and visit Koh Tao. In an ideal world, I would like to see Koh Tao evolve into something that we would, I guess, describe as an eco-island.
For me, giving up is not an option in this case.
It's not too late. If we start now, if we do it together, we can make it work.